thought it was okay. I could understand the reasons. They said there might be a man or a nervous child seeing this small piece of flesh that they weren't quite expecting. So I whispered and tiptoed with nervous discretion. But after 6 months of her life sat sitting on lids, sipping on milk, nostrils sniffing on piss, trying not to bang her head on toilet roll dispensers, I wonder whether these public loo feeds offend her. Because I am getting tired of discretion and being polite. As my baby's first sips are drowned, drenched in shite, I spent the first feeding months of her beautiful life feeling nervous and awkward and wanting everything right. Surrounded by family till I stepped out the house. It took me 8 weeks to get the confidence to go into town. Now the comments around me cut like a knife as I rush into toilet cubicles feeling nothing like nice. Because I'm giving her milk that's not in a bottle. Wishing the cocaine generation white powder would topple. I see pyramid sales pitches across our green globe and female breasts banned. Unless they're out just for show. And the more I go out, the more I can't stand it. I walk into town, feel I'm surrounded by bandits. Because in this country, a billboard's covered in tits and family newsagent magazines full of it. WH Smith top shelves out for men. Why don't you complain about them then? In this country, a billboard's covered in tits and family newsagent magazines full of it. WH Smith top shelves out for men. I'm getting embarrassed in case a small flash of flesh might offend. And I am not trying to parade this. I don't want to make a show. But when I'm told I'd be better just staying at home. And when another friend I know is thrown off a bus and another mother told to get out of a pub, even my grandma said maybe I was sexing it up. And I'm sure the milk makers love all this fuss, all the cussing and worry and looks of disgust as another mother turns from nipples to powder, ashamed or embarrassed by comments around her. And as I hold her head up and pull my cardi across and she sips on that liquor made by everyone's God, I think for God's sake Jesus drank it. So did Siddhartha, Muhammad and Moses and both of their fathers, Ganesh and Shiva and Brigid and Buddha. And I'm sure they weren't doing it, sniffing on shit as their mother sat embarrassed on cold toilet lids in a country of billboards covered in tits. In a country of low-cut tops, cleavage and skin, in a country of cloth bags and recycling bins, and as I desperately try to take all of this in, I hold her head up. I can't get my head round. The anger towards us and not to the sound of lorries offloading formula milk into countries where water runs dripping in filth, in towns where breasts are oases of life, now dried up in two-for-one offers enticed by labels and logos and gold standard rights claiming breast milk is healthier, powdered and white, packaged and branded and sold at a price so that nothing is free in this money-fueled life, which is fine if you need it or prefer to use bottles. Where water is clean and bacteria boil. But in towns where they drown in pollution and sewage, bottled kids die and they knew that they'd do it. In towns where pennies are savoured like sweets, we are now paying for one thing that has always been free. In towns empty of hospital beds, babies die, diarrhea fueled that breast milk would end. So no more will I sit on these cold toilet lids, no matter how embarrassed I feel as she sips. Because in this country of billboards, covered in tits, I think I should try to get used to this.